The unwritten rules getting quite a workout this week. Tony La Russa publicly criticizing his own player for hitting a home run on a 3-0 count when he was leading by 11. But there's something that's been missing in the debate all week, the basic tactics that brought all of this on. Now, Tony La Russa says this is an issue of sportsmanship, and I don't want to dismiss that. Sportsmanship and a code of conduct is important, even at the major leagues. But I'll start with a basic question. If Rocco Baldelli, manager of the Twins, doesn't care about the final score, why should Tony La Russa? What did La Russa think Baldelli was doing having a backup infielder pitch the ninth inning? Baldelli, again, he's the Twins manager. He's playing the long game. It's the first of a three-game series with the White Sox. Baldelli, by bringing in Willians Astudillo, a position player, to pitch, is conceding the game and the score. The answer, why? To be stronger the next day. Here's what Baldelli is looking at. He's losing 15-4 with three outs left offensively. It's the first of a three-game series with the White Sox. He then has a doubleheader with the Angels Thursday. They just played that. No off day on Thursday. Usually that happens. They had back-to-back rainouts in April, so it's off to Anaheim for a doubleheader, then straight to a weekend series in Cleveland. That's where they are right now. Baldelli knows his own schedule. Baldelli is saving his resources, and he's saying, hey, White Sox, you can beat us 40-3 tonight. It's still one win. We win the next day, also one win. He understands the math and the need for fresh arms. The four relievers used by Baldelli to finish the game on Monday, Derek Law, Sean Anderson, Jorge Alcala, and then Astudillo. Since that game, Law has been DFA'd, cut. Anderson was put on the injured list. So this is his B squad, and with Astudillo, his C squad. You want to know his A squad? Check out the box score the next day against the White Sox, by the way. Baldelli, with a reasonably rested A-squad bullpen, used six pitchers to beat the White Sox 5-4. The next day, six. Suddenly, he has plenty of pitchers. No infielders then. In the final three innings, Baldelli uses Tyler Duffey, Alex Colome, Hansel Robles, and Taylor Rogers, mixing and matching high leverage four guys in the last three innings. Four. That's good managing, by the way. Using Astudillo in a blowout is a tactical move. It saves resources. Baldelli isn't embarrassed by getting blown out. He's allowing it to happen. He's purposely making it more likely to live to fight another day, the next day with a more rested bullpen. So with that in mind, after La Russa criticized Yermín Mercedes, his own player, for hitting the home run, I was stunned by this. The audacity, the gall, the chutzpah of the Twins, then throwing at Mercedes the next day. I mean, it's stunning. Now, I get the nuance. They didn't throw at his head. They didn't buzz the tower at 97. Tyler Duffey threw behind Mercedes and at his legs. The league suspended him three games for this. But then La Russa actually said he had no problem with the Twins doing this. Well, it's good to be Rocco Baldelli then. You save a pitcher for the next day, you win a one-run game, and then you have the other manager backing you up for throwing at his player. It's like a Jedi mind trick. So what are we saying? If you bring in a position player, it's a tactical move, we get it. The normal code of conduct, though, is amended. You're inviting a beating that day. So if you get one, don't complain, because you have every intention of beating the other club the next day with the players sitting in the bullpen that you saved.